Hi, welcome back to my channel. This is Carol Creepy, and I'm here to present to you my very, very first favorites video. If you want to see my favorites is, stick around. Again, this is Carol PDB, and I'm here to present to you some of what I call my favorites. And these are just some things that I've been gravitating to and been using quite frequently when I do leave my house. So, the first thing that I'm usually grabbing to is my brushes. And the brushes that I am talking about is these beautiful set of brushes. And these are my Ovanni brushes, which I purchased off of eBay. And these are a set of 29 brushes. And like I said, these are the brushes that I purchased off of eBay. And when I tell you, these brushes are fabulous. Yes, my love. I am in love with these brushes. I mean, the texture of them is incredible. I love them to death. I mean, you can't go wrong with them. Some brushes I've added in here, like my contour brush, which I do love. And also, these little things that I purchased from eBay. They were $1.39. They come in a very long thing. You can put them over your brushes so that you can keep their shape. I also purchased this brush, the contour brush, off of eBay as well for $2. And I'm telling you, don't sleep on eBay, because eBay, what? They got some serious bargains out there that you can't even sleep on. I'm telling you, y'all. Don't sleep on it. But, yeah, that's eBay my shit. I'm telling y'all. But, these brushes, no joke. The second thing I be gravitating to with my makeup, and y'all got to excuse me, is my blender, my beauty blender, and I'm in love with this. I'm in so much love with this. This thing is amazing. When I tell you, when it comes to blending in your makeup and that flawless finish, this is it right here. This is, I believe, the Real Techniques blender. Amazing. Amazing. I love it. When you wet it and you use it, I never did understand why most folks would wet their blenders, but then I tried it and it actually gives you that gorgeous, flawless finish. Amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. And like I said, that's that Real Techniques flawless finish. Then the next item that I've fallen in love with, and reason being is like sometimes I do my tutorials late night and I don't feel like putting on lashes, what I would gravitate to is my unique 3D lash gel. And it looks like this. It has two in there. One of them is your fiber and one is your gel. What I like about it is that it comes in this case. Very pretty. And you can go ahead and store your stuff in here. When I tell you these are a lifesaver, it is amazing. The application, not a problem. When I tell you that these make your lashes look so full and gorgeous, it is not a joke. I mean, lifesaver when you just don't feel like going through the hassle with that damn glue and have to sit there. This is it right here. The unique 3D fiber. Honey, let me tell you, we're in love. seriously in love. Then I have my studio fix in my, what do you call it? NC50? Yes, Lord. I'm hitting Pam. I don't play with this. I don't play with this. No. Can you hear the angels sing when I open it? They're a little rusty, but did you hear them? Come on. This stuff, I can't even go into it. It's a savior. I can't begin. I can't begin. I love this stuff. I use it as a powder. I use it if I want to just run out real quick. So God, this is all you need. This is all you need. Yeah. Do your fix. Let me tell you. Next item that I have fallen in love with and have been gravitating to for my highlight is the Becca. And no, this ain't champagne one, cause honey, no. This is just your basic highlight, and she looks like this. As you can see, nothing special about her, nothing special. She's just your simple highlight with your little light. Very pigmented little girl. Mm-hmm. You see her there. I don't know how she's showing up, because this sucker ain't even got no autofocus. I ain't even got none. But yes, I'm in love with her. She's gorgeous. She's gorgeous when she hits you. Yeah. Loving it. And this is Miss Becca. And you know, let me tell you, when it comes to buying the high-end items, I'm sorry, I mean, I have to really, really say to myself, okay, I need it, because I just can't. I can't see myself spending $60-$70 on a palette. I just can't see it. I can't do it. I mean, that's like decisions. Do you eat tomorrow? Do you pay a bill? Or you buy a palette? And then, to me, a brown, to me, looks the same in every palette. I mean, I just can't see the difference, really. Call me strange. I will continue to use a palette until I just can't see the pigmentation in it anymore. And then I will switch. But after that, I just can't see it. I can't see me spending that much on a palette. I just can't. And call me cheap, but I just can't. It's weirdness to me. It's weird. But on these, I'll spend some money, and that's on my ColourPop. I love these. It's been a while since I've been able to hit them up, because you know I've been up and down, sick, but this tray right here I was in love with. It came with 6 shades, and when I tell you, these shades are gorgeous. Yes, Lord, these are gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. I mean, pigmentation for days. For days. You just swipe a few of them so you can see. I mean, this blue one, she's called Baby. I don't know if you can see that. That's Baby. The next one I'm going to give you a quick look at, she's called Melrose. Beautiful brown one. I don't know if you can see that one. She's right next to the blue. She's right there. That's beautiful Melrose. Then we have this beautiful gold. And I mean, this is just gorgeous. Gorgeous. She's right there. And she is called, Crimper. That's what she's called. And I don't know if you can see it on camera how she looks or any justice is done to her. But honey, let me tell you, okay? And then we got, Kush. She's kind of, a little bit of a silver kind of color to her. That's her right there. Let me tell you, when you're used to something, you just used to do it certain ways. And this camera, I just can't get used to. So, y'all just need to bear with me on that. The next one, she is called, what is she called? 90210. And she is like a dark brownish kind of, it's like a dark kind of gold. That's her right there. I mean, real pretty. And I think I did swatches of these, but I've been gravitating towards this whenever I go out, and I love it. I love it. I mean, pigmented for days, and I'm loving this palette. This ColourPop. Child, please. This is also another palette I'm loving. Their colors are, I mean, gorgeous. The shimmer, the pigmentation, I mean, amazing. Amazing, 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 amazing. And this is your Perfusion palette, which is a palette that I purchased off of eBay. Gorgeous, gorgeous. I also used this in the challenge that was done by a young lady here on YouTube named Maria. And she did a challenge, which I did have a video up. You might have seen it yesterday. Providing that it did go up. But it was makeup with highlight. Yeah. Being that I'm of dark persuasion, African American, I went ahead and did my take on it, and I used some of these colors to do highlighted colors on my face to represent highlights to get that effect. And honey, you couldn't get more pigmented with these colors than anything. I mean, amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. And they worked out perfect. So perfect. So, I couldn't tell you. Could not tell you. It was not a loss. Then, this one is a recent one that I fell in love with. And I mean, my love for this is because it gives your skin a dewiness, and it actually holds your makeup. And I mean, for me, it was amazing when I heard about it. It was strange, but it was amazing because of the results that I got from it. It actually made your makeup look like skin, but it gave you a dewiness to it. And that is the Nivea for Men, the post-shaving balm in Sensitive. That is this right here, and I'm in love with this. Nikki Tutorial was the one that introduced this to us YouTubers in the makeup field, and this was and is awesome. When I tell you this was not a bust, it is not. It does have a strong smell for a manly type, but when I tell you it's worth the shot, it is really worth trying out. Fabulous. Fabulous on your skin. I mean, it just gives your makeup that skin look. I mean, you can't go wrong with it. Cannot go wrong. And my final that I have been loving, and I mean, since I've discovered this, I have not gone back to my banana powder more than anything. I have been hooked to this, and I'm telling you, if you use this, you'll be hooked too, because the fineness of this, the lightness of this powder is just amazing. Amazing. And I mean, I would suggest though, if you're gonna buy it, go through eBay first, because you'll get it way cheaper on eBay before you go anywhere else. And what I am speaking about is the beautiful Miss Laura Mercier setting powder. Yes, darling. This bitch here is no joke. You hear me? She is no joke. She is so finely milled. It is amazing. I mean, amazing. When I tell you, she is not playing. She's not playing, honey. She sets so beautifully. The right amount on your face, you don't even have to brush it off. You just put it on and it just sets. Butter. You hear me? It's like butter. This is gorgeous. This is gorgeous. I don't know how to tell you. It's flawlessly gorgeous. Gorgeous. I don't know what to tell you. You just have to get it and try it yourself. That's all I can tell you. I mean, you won't regret it. You will not regret it. It is so finely milled. It is not a joke. I mean, gorgeous. Then, as far as new finds that I have found and discovered through some other look around and what I think of them, the latest found that I've gotten is this brush. And this brush was reviewed by the beautiful Platinum D. And I've seen this brush in Sephora, and it is a dupe of the Marc Jacobs brush. And when I tell you, this brush is no joke, honey, this brush is no joke. This brush is regularly in Sephora for about $78-$80. Not a joke. This is what I would call the best dupe I've ever seen. The only thing missing off of this is the name. This brush is amazing. It is so, and you gotta excuse the look of it, because I've been using it. This brush is amazing. It is so soft. It is nice, fluffy. It is an amazing brush. It is so amazing. I mean, you can, honey, yes, baby. Not a joke. Look at it, and then go to Sephora. Yes, baby. I ain't even gonna tell you how much it is. I'm just gonna put the link. Because if I tell you how much I paid for it, you ain't gonna believe me. I had to catch two of them. You hear me? You ain't gonna believe me. I'll put it this way. I paid less than $5 for this. No different from the $80 brush in Sephora. You hear what I'm telling you? Link will be in the description. You hear me? Yes. And I'll put the link for these little things too, because these are perfect for protecting your brushes, keeping the shape even when you wash them. Perfect. The verdict on these brushes here is still out. It is still out for me. I still gotta get used to them. And that is the Artis brush. Yes, I finally got the whole kitten caboodle, but the verdict for me is still out on them. I'm still trying to get the hang of them, still trying to get used to them. So I don't want to say nay, yay. don't want to say nothing bad about these brushes, because I'm still trying with them. So, but I will say this, they're soft as hell. They are soft. They feel amazing. But it's just, I have to get used to the application process of these brushes. I mean, they're beautiful brushes, I won't lie. They are beautiful brushes, but I just have to get used to the application of them. That's basically it. But everybody else that I've seen, they love them. They say they're amazing. I'm still learning. So, I'm not gonna lie and tell you that. I'm not here to tell you, get something, and I honestly don't have a good feeling about it or whatever. Y'all know that. I'm gonna tell y'all straight up, whether it's good or bad, y'all gonna hear it straight from me. I mean, you have vendors out there that don't like that. They don't want to hear the bad. They don't want the honest opinion of us when we tell you that. No, you're gonna get the honest opinion of me, and I'm not gonna tell you, oh, I liked it, it was great, it was fabulous, and deep down it was like shit. No. So my honest opinion on these is that I can't give you one, because I'm still trying to figure the use of these to get the hang on getting my foundation on correctly with these. So the verdict is still out on them, but they are beautiful. That's where I stand with it. So that and this was my first favorites video. I am so proud of myself. I got one out there. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed getting the stuff together to bring this to you. And I can't thank you enough for taking the time and the patience to sit there and listen to me ramble on the stuff that I consider my favorites and what I've been using. And I can't thank you enough. So, if you have any comments, questions, or any suggestions on what you would like to see me do, go ahead and make those notations down at the bottom. If you enjoyed it, thumbs up, gettin. Hey, we take it down too. Thumbs it down. We take realness here, so. But I thank you so much, my newbies. Welcome. Thank you for joining the family. My ride and dies. Always love to see you, my baby. And again, this is Carol PVB saying we love you always. And I thank you again. Take care, my beauties. Bye, babies.